हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज श्रावण। दिस इज माय यूट्यूब चैनल सिविल इंजीनियरिंग बाय श्रावण। टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल क्लिक ऑन सब्सक्राइब बटन एंड क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकन फॉर मोर इंटरेस्टिंग अपडेट्स। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू एनालिसिस एंड डिजाइनिंग ऑफ जी प्लस 8 स्टोरी सेटबैक बिल्डिंग बाय यूजिंग स्टार्प्रो V8A सॉफ्टवेयर। सो इनिशियली आई विल शो यू द मॉडल फॉर द रेस्पेक्टिव सेटबैक बिल्डिंग ऑफ जी प्लस 8 स्टोरी। गो टू दिस स्टार्प्रो सॉफ्टवेयर। सो दिस इज माय जी प्लस 8 स्टोरी बिल्डिंग। आई वॉज डन मॉडल फॉर दिस रेस्पेक्टिव स्ट्रक्चर। So it will be consisting of 21 meter length and 15 meter width and 27 meter height for this respective structure. So I will model this respective model in StatPro software. So after modeling process is completed, I will analyze this respective structure. I will check the shear force value, bending moment diagram, as well as the deflection values. So after that, I will design this G+8 story building by using IS456 2000 code. So for that, initially go to StatPro software here. So click on new project, click on spacing here, give the structure name. Just I am assuming the structure name is G+8. Save your file location. Just I am taking my file location to the desktop, G+8, click on OK. So here we need to select the length units will be in meter as well as force units will be in kilonewton. Click on next button, click on finish button. The software will be open like this. So initially we need to keep the structure in front of you. So after that we need to model the G+8 story building. So initially I will model bottom 3 stories. So for that initially go to geometry option here. Click on run structure wizard option. So here we need to select the model type. This time selecting it as the frame models. Select the bay frame option. So here we need to assume the length of the building, height of the building, width of the building and number of base along length direction, number of base along height direction and number of base along width direction. Just I am assuming length of the building will be consisting of 21 meter and I am assuming height of the building will be consisting of 3 multiplied by 3 will give you 9 meter. Width of the building is 15 meter. So after that we need to assume the number of base along length, height, width direction. Just I am taking number of base along length direction as 7. Again I am taking number of base along height direction as 3. Again I am taking number of base along width direction as 5. Click on apply button. Click on apply button. The model will be open like this. So this is my 3-story building from the ground. So we need to import this respective frame models from structure wizard option to StatPro software. So for that initially go to file option here, click on merge model with StatPro option here, click on yes button, click on OK. The model is directly imported to StatPro software now. So after that click on hide snap node grid. Again we need to keep the structure in top view. So here we need to delete all unnecessary beams and column sections for this respective structure. So just I am taking this beams as well as column sections are unnecessary members for this respective structure. So click on delete option, click on yes button. So it will delete all unnecessary beams and column sections for this respective 3 stories. So after that we need to click on 3D view again. So after that we need to model one more 3 stories for this respective structure. So for that again keep your structure in front of you. Click on cut section command option here, click on selective view option here, click on OK. So here we need to select all these respective sections. Again we need to click on top view for this respective building. So here we need to select all beams and column sections. Just I am selecting this beams and column sections for this respective structure. So after that again I am selecting beams and column sections. So after that keep your structure in 3D view. So here we need to copy these respective beams and column sections to the remaining 3 steps. So for that go to transitional repeat option in y direction. So here I am assuming number of steps will be of 3 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on link steps options, click on OK. So it will copy the beams and column sections to the remaining 3 stories. So after that click on whole structure command again. Again we need to keep the structure in front of you option. Again we need to create remaining 3 stories. So for that again click on cut section command, click on selective view option, click on OK. So here we need to cut the top story for this respective structure. Again we need to click on top view for this respective model. So here we need to select the 3x3 frame sections. Just I am selecting this frame sections. Click on 3D view again. Again select the transitional repeat in Y direction. So here we need to assume the number of steps will be 3 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on link steps options, click on OK. So it will copy the respective beams and columns to the remaining 3 stories. So after that we need to click on whole structure command model. So this is my G+8 story setback building for the respective frame sections. So after adding the beams and column sections, we need to add the slab section for this respective structure. So for that, initially we need to click on front view option, click on cut section command. Here we need to select the selective view option, click on OK. So here we need to cut the ground story for this respective model. So again, click on top view. So here we need to select add four node plate option. This time I'm selecting first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point. So after adding the slab section for this respective grid, we need to copy the respective slab to the remaining sections. So for that, we need to select plate cursor here. This time I'm selecting in 3D view, select this respective plate. So we need to copy this respective plate in Z direction as well as X direction. So for that, go to transitional repeat. This time I'm selecting in X direction. So here we need to count the number of steps here. This time I'm selecting number of steps are 5 here. So here we need to assume the number of steps are 5. And each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So it will copy the respective slab to the remaining 5 steps. So after that, we need to select all slab members. We need to copy this respective slab members in this Z direction distance. So again, we need to select the transitional repeat in Z direction. And number of steps will be 4. And each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So it will copy the slab members to the remaining sections. So again, we need to select these 2 slab sections. Again, go to transitional repeat in X direction. Number of steps will be 1 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So after that, we need to click on host structure command. Again, we need to select the plate cursor here. Select all the plates. We need to copy these respective plates to the remaining 2 steps. So for that, again, we need to select the transitional repeat in Y direction. Number of steps will be 2 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So it will copy the respective slab to the remaining 2 stories. So we need to see this respective whole model in 3D rendering view now. Click on 3D rendering view. So this is my 3D rendering view for this respective structure. So here I was created the slab members for the bottom 3 stories. So we need to create the slab members for the remaining 6 stories. So for that, again we need to select front view option, click on cut section command, selective view option, click on OK. So here we need to select the beam. This time selecting this respective beams. Again select 3D view option, click on add 4 node plate option. Again we need to add the 4 node plate for the corner section. So again we need to copy this respective slab member to the X direction as well as Z direction. Select this respective plate cursor. This time selecting this plate, click on transitional repeat. So here I am selecting in X direction, which is consisting of 3 steps and each step will be of 3 meter. Click on OK. So again we need to select this 4 steps, click on transitional repeat in Z direction. So here I am selecting number of steps here, this time taking it as 3 and each step will be of 3 meter. Click on OK. So here we need to delete one slab section. So for that, select plate cursor, this time selecting this respective plate, click on delete option, click on OK. So here we need to click on hold structure command. So again we need to select front view. So we need to copy the respected slab section to the remaining 2 stories. So for that, select plate cursor option. This time selecting these respective plates, click on transitional repeat option in Y direction. Number of steps will be 2 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So it will copy the respective slab member to the remaining 2 stories. So I will show you this respective model in 3D rendering view now. So click on 3D rendering view option. So this is the rendering view for this respective structure. So here I was created a slab section for the remaining 3 stories. So for that, again click on modeling option, again front view option, click on cut section command, click on selective view option, click on OK. So here we need to cut this respective section. Again we need to select the 3D view, select add 4 node plate option. This time selecting first point, second point, third point, fourth point. So again we need to select the plate cursor. Again select plate, click on transitional repeat option in X direction. This time taking number of steps will be consisting of 2 steps and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. Again I am selecting these 3 plates, transitional repeat option. Again I am Z direction. This time selecting it as 2 and 3. Click on OK. So it will copy the respective slab member to the remaining sections. Click on host structure command. Again we need to select in front view option, select the plate cursor. So here we need to select this respective plate. We need to copy this respective plates to the remaining 2 stories. So for that, click on transitional repeat option in Y direction. Number of steps will be 2 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So it will copy the respective slab to the remaining two stories. So after that we need to see this respective whole model in 3D rendering view. So click on 3D rendering view option. So this is my 3D rendering view for this respective G plus 8 story setback building. So after modeling this respective structure, we need to give the properties for this respective building. So initially we need to define the beam size, column size as well as slab thickness for this building. So for that go to general option here, click on properties option, click on define option. So here we need to select the rectangular section. Just I am assuming beam size will be consisting of 0.3 × 0.4. Click on add button. Again I am selecting the column size which is consisting of 0.5 × 0.4. Click on add option, close option. So again we need to click on thickness option. So here I am assuming plate thickness will be consisting of 125 mm. Click on add button, close option. So after that select 0.3 × 0.4, nothing but the beam sections. So go to select option, beams parallel to x direction. Again go to select option, beams parallel to z direction. Click on assign to selected beams, assign, yes. So after that we need to select the column sections. Go to select 0.5 × 0.4, go to select option, beams parallel to y direction. Click on assign to selected beams, assign, yes. So after that select the plate thickness by using assign to view option, assign, yes. So here we need to see this respective whole model in rendering view now. So for that click on rendering view option. So this is my rendering view for this respective G plus 8 story setback building. It will be consisting of 0.3 × 0.4 is the beam size and 0.5 × 0.4 is the column size, and slab thickness will be consisting of 125 mm. So after giving the properties for this respective building, we need to define the supports. So for that go to supports options here, click on create option, add your fixed support, select your support to. By using front view option, we need to select all the node points at the base. By using assign to selected nodes option, click on assign, click on yes button. So it will assign the respective fixed supports at the base. So after that we need to apply the load cases for this respective building. So for this building, just I am assuming load cases will be consisting of dead load, live load, floor load, earthquake load as well as wind load. So along with these load cases, I will add the load combinations also. So for that initially we need to define the load case details like seismic load and wind load. So for that go to click on load case and definitions option here, click on plus mark here. So here we need to select the seismic definitions, click on add button. So here we need to select the type. This time selecting it as IS 1893-2002. Click on generate option. So here I am assuming zone 5, which is consisting of 0.36 is the seismic coefficient value, and the response reduction will be 5. Just I am selecting it as all general buildings with importance factor is 1 for the respected medium soil condition, which is having damping ratio of 0.05. Click on generate option. So it will generate the properties for this respective building as per IS 1893-2002 code. Click on add button. So after that we need to add the self weight for this respective building. Again we need to select the member weight here. Just I am selecting it as uniform load. So here we need to calculate the uniform load for this respective beam section. So here I am selecting the calculator. So here I am taking 0.3 × 0.4 is the beam size. We need to multiply this respective beam with the unit weight of the concrete. So it will give the value of 3 here. So we need to give the weight value is 3. Click on add button. So after that click on close option, select this uniform weight of 3, go to select option here, beams parallel to x direction. Again we need to select option, beams parallel to z direction. Click on assign to selected beams option, assign, yes. So after that we need to define the wind load case. So for that select wind definitions option here, click on add button. So here we need to add the type 1 window initially, click on add button, close option. So after that select type 1 wind 1 option, click on add button. So here we need to give the value of intensity for the respective height. Just I am assuming intensity will be consisting of 1 kN per meter square, which is acting at a distance of 27 meters. Again I am taking intensity will be 0.5, which is acting at a distance of 18 meters. Again I am taking the 0.3, which is acting at a distance of 9. Again I am taking 0.1, which is acting at a distance of 3. Click on add button. So after that we need to add the exposure value as 1, add it, close it. So after that select exposure 1 by using assign to view option, assign, yes. So after that we need to define the load case details. So for that, go to select your lowercase details option, click on add button. So here we need to initially define the seismic load. Just I am selecting seismic load here, earthquake load in x direction, add it. Again I am selecting earthquake load in z direction, add it. Again select your wind load option. This time I am selecting the load title as WX, click on add button. Again I am selecting it as WZ, click on add button. Select the dead load option here. This time I am adding load case number 5 as DL, add it. Again I am selecting the live load option. This time I am selecting it as LL, add button. Again select your roof live option. This time I am selecting the floor load here, close option here. Again select earthquake load in x direction option, click on add button. So here we need to add the seismic load in x direction with factor 1, add button, close option. Select earthquake load in z direction by using add button. Select your respective seismic load in z direction with factor 1, add button, close button. Select wind load in x direction, click on add button. Select the value of wind load here. Just I am selecting the wind load option in x direction windward face which is having factor of 1, click on add button. Again we need to add the minus 1 factor in opposite direction, click on add button, close option. Select wind load in z direction by using add button. Select wind load here, again in z direction with the factor 1, add button. Again I am selecting it as minus 1, click on add button, close option. So after that we need to select the dead load option here. Select DL, click on add button. Just I am adding self weight factor, add it, close it. Select the live load option, click on add button. So here we need to select the floor load option which is consisting of minus 3 which is acting at a distance of 3 and 27, click on add button, close option. So after that select this respective Y range. So this is the live load for this respective building. So after that select the floor load option by using add button. Select the floor load option which is having pressure of minus 1.5 at a distance of 1 and 27, click on add button, close option. Select self weight option by using assign to view. So here we need to select assign to view option, assign, yes. So after that we need to add the load combinations for this respective G plus 8 story building. Select load case details by using add button. Select auto load combination generation. Select here as Indian code. Click on generate loads here. So it will generate the load combinations for this building like this. Click on add button, close option. So after that select the materials properties. Select your respective concrete material by using assign to view option, assign, yes. Go to analysis and print, add your no print option, click on close option. Go to analyze option, click on run analysis, click on save button. So here we need to check for the zero errors for this respective model. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode, click on done option, select apply button, click on OK. So this is the deflection diagram due to presence of the dead load case. Due to presence of dead load case, the building will be deflected in downward direction. Select earthquake load in x direction, earthquake load in z direction, wind load in x, wind load in z. Select dead load, select live load, select floor load. So this is the different types of load combinations deflection diagram. Select beam option here. Select Fy value, deselect the Mz value. So this is the shear force diagram for this respective building due to presence of earthquake load in x direction, earthquake load in z direction, wind load in x, wind load in z. So this is the dead load shear force diagram, live load shear force diagram, floor load shear force diagram. So after that select Mz value, so deselect Fy value. Next I am selecting earthquake load in x direction. So this is the bending moment diagram due to presence of earthquake load in x, earthquake load in z, wind load in x, wind load in z, dead load. So select the live load option, select the floor load. So this is the different types of combinations bending moment diagram. So after that select the plate, apply your stress type as maximum absolute pressure, apply, okay. So this is the maximum absolute pressure for this respective building due to presence of earthquake load in x direction, earthquake load in z direction, wind load in x, wind load in z, dead load, live load, floor load. So after that select animation button, click on deflection, apply, okay. So this is the deflection due to presence of floor load. Select earthquake load in x direction, earthquake load in z direction, wind load in x direction, wind load in z direction, dead load, live load, floor load. So after analysis part is completed, we need to design this respective building as per IS 456-2000 code. So further click on modeling option here, click on design option here, select the concrete design. So initially we need to select IS 456 code. Just I'm selecting IS 456 here. Click on select parameters. Initially we need to deselect all selected parameters. We need to select compressed strength, yield strength of shear reinforcement, maximum main, maximum secondary reinforcement. Click on OK. Again we need to click on define parameters. For this building, just I am assuming M40 grade concrete 40,000. Click on add button. Again I am selecting FY main. Just I am selecting it as 600,000. Click on add button. Again I am selecting section reinforcement also 600,000. Click on add button. Select maximum main 16 mm bars. Click on add button. Maximum secondary 16 mm bars. Click on add button. Close option. Select the commands option, click on design beam, add button, again select the design column, click on add button, again select the design slab element, click on add button, select takeoff command, click on add button, close option. So here we need to select these respective question marks. So we need to assign these respective question marks for this respective building. Select FC by using assign to view option, assign yes. Again select FI main by using assign to view, assign yes. Again I'm selecting section reinforcement also, assign to view option, assign yes. Again select maximum main also, assign to view, assign yes. Maximum secondary, assign to view, assign yes. Select design beam, go to select option, beams parallel to x direction. Again go to select option, beams parallel to z direction. By using assign to selected beams, assign yes. Again select design column, go to select option, beams parallel to y direction. By using assign to selected beams, assign yes. Select design element by using assign to view, assign yes. So after that go to analysis and print option, add your no print option, close option. So here we need to go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. So here we need to check for the zero errors for this respective design also. So here my model is checking for the zero errors as per IS 456-2000 code. So here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode, click on done button. So deselect the deflection diagram. So select beam, so just select any one of the beam. Just I'm selecting beam number 538. Just double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design for this respective beam. It will be consisting of 11 bars of 12 mm dia, 269 center to center distance, and bottom reinforcement will be consisting of 11 bars of 10 mm dia, 30 center to center distance, and stirrups will be consisting of 10 bars of 8 center to center distance. Click on close option. Again we need to select any one of the column section. Just I am selecting this respective column 180 number, double click on it, click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design for this respective section. It will be consisting of 8 number of bars of 16 mm dia, and AST percentage is 0.80, and AST requirement is 1600 mm² for the respective M40 grade concrete and FE 600 grade steel. Click on close option. So after designing the beam as well as column, we need to see the STAD output file for this respective model. So for that click on STAD output file option here. So it will load the respective STAD output file like this. So it will be consisting of 606 in total number of pages. Click on results option, click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design for this respective beam as well as column section as well as slab results. So after designing the slab as well as the beam and column, we need to design the foundation. So for that go to select your foundation design. So initially we need to select the load cases. This time selecting load cases as earthquake load, wind load, dead load, live load, flow load. Click on include option. So select your run STAD foundation here. The fixed supports of this respective G plus 8 story building will be directly imported to STAD foundation software. So these are the fixed supports. We need to design the foundation for these respective fixed supports as per IS 456-2000 code. Just I am assuming isolated footing for these respective fixed supports. So initially we need to create the load combinations. So for that, select your loads and factors. Click on generate load combination as Indian code. Click on generate load combinations for the surface load combination initially. So click on OK. So after that, click on generate load combinations for the ultimate load combination. Click on OK. So after that, click on create job here. Select create new job option. Select job name. Just I am selecting job name as some name. Isolated footing, which is consisting of Indian code, and the units will be in SI assigned to all supports. So here we need to select load combinations. Just I am selecting load combinations as 101, 102, 201, 202, 203, 204. So we need to include these load cases. Click on create job. So it will create the isolated footing job like this. So after that, select this place mark option, design and parameters, select concrete and rebar value. So this is the concrete and rebar value for this respective foundation. Click on cover and soil type, footing geometry values, sliding and overturning values. Click on design option. Click on S button. So it will design this respective foundation as per IS 456-2000 code. So after 2 minutes of analysis, my STAD output file is showing like this. Just I am selecting isolated footing 4. So this is the each and individual calculation for isolated footing 4 as per IS 456-2000 code. So this is the calculation sheet for this respective foundation. So select your starting page. This is the starting page, geometry, details and drawing. So this is the details and drawing for this respective foundation. So click on GA drawing here, click on calculation sheet. So this is the process analysis and designing of G+8 story setback building by using StatPro V8i software. Thank you.